Thank you. Thank you. Welcome once again to a very special New Year's Eve edition of 321. In fact, we're going back to the beginning tonight because our theme is very, very special. The Garden of Eden. We're calling it Come Into the Garden Eve. And we've got some surprises for you a bit later on. Now, I mean, of course, we're going back, as I say, to when time began, you know, when man lived alone and really was contented. And you all know why, don't you? Because woman hadn't been invented. No, I didn't mean that. But I've not forgotten about that serpent in the Garden of Eden. There was the serpent, and when Adam saw him, he said to the Lord, "Here, what's that snake doing down here?" And the Lord said, "Adam, meet your mother-in-law." He didn't really do that. Now, I would like you to come along, folks at home, and meet the only bin on earth. That's my little mate, Dusty Bin. Here he is, right down here. And look at him. Indeed, look at him. That's our raw receptacle there. He's down to the bare metal. But remember, there is a hidden secret. Yes? That's not the hidden secret under that fig leaf. You know what happens. If you win him, of course, all you do is to get a brand new dustbin. And by that, I'm talking about our contestants, the people who we just couldn't do the show without. Will you say hello to them right now?
Eric and Ruth Ryan from Chesterfield. Jack and Dora Morgan from Wilmslow. And Pip Thompson from Birmingham.
Yes, lovely. Lovely audience, lovely contestants. And our first two tonight are Harry and Pip Thompson from Birmingham. Hey?
Yes.
Yeah, lovely. Which part of Birmingham are you from?
Rednall.
Rednall. Oh, yeah, I know that. Know that.
Yeah.
I see. Now, what intrigues me here, actually, that you both like motor racing. And you go as often as possible, yes?
Yes. Ready?
And you also video the races, and you play them back in full stereo sound.
That's right.
For more noise.
That's right, yes. Oh. Get the real atmosphere, don't
you? You like Niki Lauda louder, do you?
You've got it, yes.
Is that true? Yeah. You really do like it?
Yes, love it, love it. Yeah. Oh, the noise is part of it.
Exciting. She's got a gorgeous accent. And how about this? You went to America. You visited there recently, didn't you? Or was it recently?
Yes.
Where did you go?
Disneyland.
Yeah? And did you go
World.
To the studios?
In Universal Studios.
What did you see there? What was the most impressionable thing?
Star Trek.
Yeah.
You've seen Star Trek?
Yeah, I saw that.
I mean, Psycho House, Jaws, Star Trek. The day I went to see Star Trek, the Captain Kirk, he had a cold, so they had to beam him up a Scotty. Nice to have you here. Make him feel at home. Good to hear. Now, Eric and Ruth Bryan, and you're from, I've got this right, Cupthorpe.
Yes.
Cupthorpe, which is in Derbyshire.
That's correct.
Now, whereabouts is that, Eric?
Near Chesterfield.
Crooked Spire Town.
Where?
Crooked Spire Town.
Crooked Spire Town. That's what they call it, is it? Lovely. You're a retired works engineer, Eric.
Yes.
And Ruth, you do work now for the Women's Institute.
Yes.
Yeah, very worthy cause there. And you've got a pastime here, a bit of an unusual one. You like collecting and making patchwork quilts.
I do.
Really?
Yes.
How many have you got?
I've got a collection of eight.
Well, that should keep you warm.
The oldest is 150.
I love this, but you saw a TV show being made in Olympia in 1937.
That's right.
Really? Yes. Is that really
old?
Right?
Yes, that's correct.
Just how old you are. Well, if you like to see that camera there, that camera was used in that television show.
Oh, dear.
I can feel it up, will you? Dora and Jack Morgan are from Wilmslow, Cheshire. I know Wilmslow used to be an RAF station there, don't you?
Yes, indeed.
I see. And what about you, Jack? You used to be in catering, eh? Mm-hmm. As well as working in this country, but you travelled the world in merchant navy.
I did indeed. Yes.
I see. So, what countries catered for you? Did you go everywhere?
Oh, pretty well everywhere, I should think. Yes. Mm-hmm. Very few places I didn't manage.
You were introduced, were you, by relatives, and you met on Brighton Promenade? Is that right?
That's correct.
And whose relatives introduced who?
My relatives
introduced you. Don't you wish relatives are sometimes minor relatives?
Yes, there's more of them.
Yeah, never mind. Make them feel welcome, folks, will you? Nice that you're here. Okay. Right, as you know, 3-2-1 always starts with a quiz. Two rounds of questioning, £10 each correct answer in the first round. Whatever they win at the end of the first round is the amount they play for each correct answer in the second. At the end of the quiz, coupled with the lowest amount of money, says goodbye to us right at that moment. Let's meet the lady with the questions. Caroline Munro is here. Caroline. Come into the garden, Eve. You wouldn't need another invitation with a dress like that. Knockout.
Oh,
good you're with
you.
Us. Let's play the quiz, shall we? Okay, Pip and Harry, choose one of those three envelopes, would you?
Thank you.
Okay, thanks a lot, Caroline. They laugh at anything, this lot. It's great. Okay. Now, you know, we'd like you to answer alternately, Pip. That's you first, of course. Two ways we can stop you if you make a mistake or run out of time. And if you don't know an answer, please just say, don't know, pass. Then I'll go on to your partner with the next question. And believe me, that way you can build up your score. Because once you do answer, and if you're wrong, I must accept the first answer you give me. Okay. Yeah. This question is about the names of well-known film stars. We will give you the surname of a well-known star, and we want you to give us his or her first name. So first names of stars. Now, Miss Bacall had the first name Lauren. We'll start you with that one, Pip. Miss Bacall had the first name of...
Lauren.
Right. Garbo.
Greta.
Astaire.
Fred.
Finch.
Albert.
No. I'm sorry, it was Peter Finch is what we wanted, Harry.
Okay,
or John Finch, another well-known film star. We would have accepted, but that is wrong. That's why I say, you know, if you don't know, say don't know. Don't take the chance. You could build your score up. However, you've got three, right? So that gives you £30. That's not a bad start. £30 next time, each correct answer. Okay, Eric and Ruth, one of those two envelopes is for you. There we are. That's the one Ruth has chosen, and good luck to you. £10 each correct answer. Same thing. If you don't know, just say don't know. This question here is about the names of well-known film stars. We will give you the surname of a well-known star. We want you to give us his or her first name. So first names of stars. Now, Miss Gish had the first name Lillian. We'll start you with that one. Gish and...
Lillian.
Simmons.
Pass.
Brando.
Marlon.
Eastwood.
Flint.
Cardinale.
Claudia.
Winters.
Pass.
Lancaster.
Bert.
Rathbone.
Pass.
Coleman.
Ronald.
Harlow.
Jean.
Yes, indeed, Jean. I could hear a few whispers if you like to keep quiet. It's not easy when you're up here trying to answer that. I know a few of you were right on that one because Rathbone was Basil. Basil Rathbone. Remember that villain? Great actor.
Yes.
Winters? Shelley Winters is what we wanted there. And Simmons, of course, that lovely Jean. Lady, Jean Simmons. Yes. Now you know. Yes. However, you've not done bad at the end. You've got seven right, £70. That's nice. Well done. Good. Okay, Caroline, thank you. The last envelope, so that means that's the one for Dora and Jack. Good luck to you. I tell you the difference. When we get the folks who are a little more mature on the show, they don't bother about holding hands. All the young couples, they grab each other. However, here's your question. It's about the names of well-known film stars. We will give you a surname and of a well-known star. We want you to give us his or her first name. First names of stars. Miss de Havilland had the first name Olivia. We'll start you with that one. De Havilland and...
Olivia.
Lola Brigida.
Gina.
Cagney.
James.
McQueen.
Puss.
Garland.
Judy.
Dietrich.
Marlene.
Lemon.
John.
Sorry?
John.
John?
Lemon, you said.
Yes?
John.
John, no, I'm sorry, it's Jack Lemon. That's why I said, pardon, I misheard there for a moment, but it was, in fact, Jack Lemmon, not John. I'm glad I did sort of hang on in there. However, McQueen, the other one we wanted was Steve. Steve McQueen, you've got five right, and that gives you £50. So it's not a bad first round. Not bad at all. A good first round. Right. That means that's couple number one, Pip and Harry, have got £30. There's couple number three, Jack and Dora, on £50. In the lead at the moment, couple number two, Eric and Ruth, £70 they've got. Well done. Okay, Pip and Harry, second round questions. Here they come. Take one of those three envelopes. Okay then, Pip, you've chosen that one again. So again, answer alternately, and if you don't know, say pass or whatever. This question is about words in standard dictionaries which begin with the letters S-M. S-M. We will give you a definition. You give us the word. Words beginning with S-M. Burning slowly without flames is smouldering. We'll start you with that one. Burning slowly without flames is...
Smouldering.
Right. Person who imports without paying duty.
Don't know.
Act of destroying a car.
Smashing.
Grey fumes from a burning object.
Don't know.
Person who works in metal.
Smelter.
A loose overall worn by artists.
Smock.
A sense that is perceived by the nose.
Smell.
A foolish smile.
Smirk.
A blurred mark.
Smear.
And the South African Prime Minister of the 40s? We are...
Smuts.
Can I accept that? It was after the bell. No, it was just after the bell. I am sorry about that. You can't hear always in here, but I'm going a bit Mutton Jeff. That's what it is. However, it was, in fact, Smuts just after the bell. What else? Grey fumes from a burning object. Smoke was what we wanted there. Person who imports without paying duty. A smuggler. However, that's not bad. You've got £210. That's what you have. That's nice. Okay, Eric and Ruth. Thank you very much. So you're going for £70. I shouldn't have said that. They're holding hands now. Look at it. £70 for each correct answer. Your question is about words in standard dictionaries which begin with the letters ES. We give you the definition, you give us the word. Words beginning with ES. A level space by a seafront is an esplanade. We'll start you with that one. A level space by a seafront is a...
an esplanade. Right.
A wide mouth of a river.
Estuary.
Piece of written homework.
Sorry, don't know.
A moving staircase.
Escalator.
The act of getting away.
Escape.
A rough calculation of price.
Estimate.
A wild adventure.
Don't know.
A title placed after a man's name.
Pass.
A Portuguese currency.
Escudo.
Act of spying. There goes the bell. Yes, I held it. I certainly held it. Thank you very much. I heard that one all right. Espionage. Title placed after a man's name was Esquire. Okay, yes. We all get that one from time to time. Yes. And what else have we got? The other one was a piece of written homework, an essay. Have I missed one there? Yes, indeed, I have. Yes, you're right. A wild adventure. You know it now, yes. Escapade. You're telling me you've done well, though. £420 you got. That's mine. 420. Okay, thanks, Caroline. So here we have Jack and Dora. They're going for £50 for each correct answer. And your question is about words in standard dictionaries which begin with the letters IL. We will give you a definition. You give us the word. Words beginning with IL, something that is contrary to the law, can be described as illegal. We'll start you with that one. Something described that is contrary to the law is illegal. The lights at Blackpool.
Illuminations.
Pictures in a book.
Illustration.
Disease.
Pass.
A false impression.
Pass.
A person who can't read or write.
Illiterate.
A Yorkshire town.
Pass.
Homer's famous epic poem.
Iliad.
Describes writing that can't be read.
Illegible.
A state of the American Midwest.
Illinois.
Illinois is absolutely right.
I knew that one.
I know.
I didn't want to
She knew, it. But she wouldn't tell him. She couldn't tell him. That's what it was.
No,
it was Elkley.
I mean.
Yes, a Yorkshire town was
Elkley.
Saying it. Never mind. A false impression was illusion, and disease, illness is what we wanted. So at the end of that, you've got £350. £350. Well done. And the two words given to each of our couples this week spells out S-M-I-L-E-S, smiles, which we hope all of us are going to have a lot more of in 1984. But at the end of our quiz this week, we've got Harry and Pip, couple number one, £210. We've got couple number three, Jack and Dora, £350. Winners of our quiz this week, New Year's Eve, Ruth and Eric, £420. Well done. So we have to say goodbye to Pip and Harry. Well, you've still got a few hours on New Year's Eve to get out and spend some of that $210.
Yes, we will.
It's funny, you know, each week, folks, I do say to every couple that comes here, you know, don't know or pass. And it's very difficult, I know. When you know that, you can build your score up, but it's difficult here with the clock going. When you think you know it, you either say it or you don't. You took the chance, never mind. There's the £210. There's that ceramic dusty bin.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much
thank
for coming
you.
Along,
thank
Harry.
You. Thank you very much.
Bin, have a kiss.
Mm. Thoroughly enjoyed it.
Love to everybody
you.
In Birmingham.
Give
them a round of applause, thank you. Lovely people. We're going away for the break. We'll see you very, very soon on 3-2-1. Don't go too far now.
It's time for Signature Challenge.
Welcome to part two this week's New Year's Eve 3-2-1. Come into the garden. Eve is the title of our show. And we've got Eric and Ruth, who are from Cupthorpe, Derbyshire, yes? Right. And they're playing right through part two against Jack and Dora, who are from Wilmslow in Cheshire. Now, you know what happens here, don't you? At the end of each one of the items we show you, somebody will come to the table, leave a clue object, and read a rhyme. Now, when we've got three on the table, I'm going to ask each couple to select one they'd like to reject if they're that lucky couple to get through to part three where all those big prizes are and that dreadful dusty bin is. Could you do with the dustbin?
That's yes.
I'm sure you could. Not when you see him, believe me. All right, let's get on then with our theme. And first of all, where else could we go but to the Garden of Eden?
So this is it, the Garden of Eden.
paradise on earth. Looks more like Emmerdale Farm. Well, it's very pretty. It's extremely well laid out. And it's very boring. I wonder if they grow on you. You remembered. I love me. I love me not. I love me. I love me not. I love me. I love me not. Oh, charming. That really narrows the field. There isn't anybody else. I think I'll have an apple.
No.
Oh, can't be.
I said no. Can't you read?
Well, there isn't a great deal of cause for it down here, is there? I mean, I'm not exactly inundated with the daily newspapers.
You are never to pick fruit from that tree. It is forbidden.
Why, what are they? French Golden Delicious.
I'll do the funnies.
That's the trouble with this business. There's no straight men left.
That is the tree of knowledge.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't know. I mean, after all, it is your garden. Oh, I must tell you about the vicar and the parrot.
Oh, I've heard it, mate.
Oh, blimey, oh, yeah. Now, this is getting beyond the joke. Listen, tell me, are you... I knew that'd go well. Are you still there?
Always.
Oh, yeah, I'm sorry, I forgot. Look, listen, I'm the last man to complain.
You're the first man to do anything.
That's the trouble. I'm the only man to do anything.
Adam, you have everything a man could ever want in a garden.
Oh, I know. I'd open it to the public, only there isn't one. There's just one teeny weeny problem.
What's that?
I hate gardening.
Well, there are other things you can do.
Ooh.
Adam, this is for you.
Is it? Thank you. Very nice.
Ooh, for me.
Is it? Tell me, very nice. I like it. Listen, you did not look at this at rehearsals. I don't. Listen, not fair. Listen, what is it?
It's a woman.
Woman? Ooh. It's a woman. Tell me, you know, I don't like to ask this, but what is a woman?
Woman before?
I ain't never seen anyone before.
Here or anywhere else.
Well, I've been sent to keep you company, so you won't be lonely anymore. Know what I mean?
Swigging.
Well, shall we get started?
What, right now?
Well, we don't want to wait till autumn, do we? Oh, look that.
Oh, no. But, I mean, we've only just met, and you've just arrived.
Now, listen, if we're going to hang around till we've been properly introduced, we'll wait forever, because there isn't anyone to do it.
To be honest, I can hardly wait. I got fed up playing with myself. All right, here we go, 301. Double to start, and you can go first.
Oh, big deal.
Val, lovely to see you. Who else could that wonderful voice be other than Valentine Dahl? It's a marvellous voice. It's the only one, I must say. And, of course, all of us on the show this week, Val, we're all doing a pantomime somewhere. I'm down in Torquay. Where are you?
Oh, I'm in Aldershot.
You've got to be playing at the Wicked Ebenezer or something.
I am indeed.
I thought so. What a lovely voice. You've done that character before?
Yes. It's lovely. The only one worth doing if you can't sing or dance.
I'm sure you could do that. Anyway, what are you going to leave these bunches a clue?
Old Bill.
Old Bill is the clue.
He's called.
Okay, and have you got a rhyme there?
Oh, it's beautiful stuff. If the bard is drab, new Latin you'll grab.
That's all it is. It's a short one, isn't it? They're all like that. This series, just as difficult. Ladies and gentlemen, Valentine Dial. Thanks, Val. Have a good season, won't you? Bye-bye. Yeah. Here you are. When they're long, they're difficult. When they're short, they're difficult. What do you think, Jack? Any idea, Dora?
Much clearer now, but I'm quite sure that Jack will, huh?
No, she's relying on you, Jack. Yes. You got
I'm
no idea, Ruth?
Oh, I think that must be the bin.
You do already,
yeah.
Eh?
Yeah.
Okay, we'll go on and have item number two. Back to Adam and Eve, but they do seem somewhat incompatible.
Oh, Adam! another go?
Oh, it's useless. We've tried for a week now. It's very frustrating.
Oh, but I've never tried it before.
Well, I'm not exactly a veteran, but at least I knew you didn't have to throw the thing's feathers first.
Well, I did suggest that you hold the darts while I throw the board.
Ah, oh, forget it.
Well, Adam, there are other things we can do.
I'm not counting the grass again. Oh. I'm putting this away.
Well, I'm going to have an apple. Do you want one?
You can't touch that. That's the tree of knowledge.
Well, you should try some of that. Then you might want to try a bit of the other. Oh, my God.
Quite the reverse. Go on, have a nibble.
Oh, that's easier said than done around here.
I meant the apples, dear lady.
Who are you?
I'm just a humble serpent at your service.
Ooh, you're very polite for a serpent.
I'm a civil serpent.
Oh, another man.
Here, look, I know the costume's a bit thin, but don't get carried away. Why don't you try one of these lovely, juicy apples? Just think of all the knowledge you'll gain from just one bite. Yeah.
I thought I heard voices.
Yes, well, I was just talking to this nice young man.
What do you mean, man? I'm the man around here.
You could have fooled me. He wants us to try an apple.
We mustn't do that.
Yes, just one. Nobody'll miss it. And he says we'd know things if we took just one bite. There.
Ooh, you're gonna get me into trouble.
Well, I was hoping it'd be the other way around.
Long time, really, but no.
Go on, taste.
Oh! It's beginning to work! Oh, I feel wonderful! Oh, Adam, I think I can play darts.
Play darts, really? Oh, I told you I'd spread on this. Oh, it's working. I know things too.
Well, what things do you know?
I don't know, but from now on, darts is at it.
Somewhere in there is Chris Emmett.
That's right.
Or Hiss Emmett. What are you going to leave me, Chris, as the clue?
I'm going to leave you an apple. There you go.
Just an apple, all right?
The apple.
And what about the clue?
Now then, before you get the core, you might well ask for more.
How about that? Don't I?
You're asking me.
I'm asking you. Well, yeah, well, I'll ask her if you like. Anyway, we'll thank Chris Emmett.
There
Thanks, Chris.
Go, yes.
Take care. Chris Emmett, folks. Hey? Really? Oh, that's good. I asked Dora first, and there's Ruth here thinking she's got another dustbin. However, one more item. Let's get on and have item number three. Now, you know, Adam and Eve have picked the apple, and retribution is at hand.
I'll tell you, I'm really upset about the whole thing, Eve. I'll tell you something. You've really done it now.
Well, I didn't do it on my own, did I?
Why, I'm talking about the apple.
And I'm talking about the...
Oh, you don't realize how serious it is. That tree was forbidden.
Oh, Adam.
It's even got a notice on it. I'll tell you, something terrible's going to happen now.
Oh, dear.
Just when you don't need one, a warden.
Ha ha! Poor pigtails are. Is it yours?
Well, yes and no.
Yes and no?
Well, no.
No, I see. Taking away and eating without the owner's consent.
Actually, he meant yes.
Now, the core was picked here, sir, and picked, if I'm not mistaken, without lights. That's a very serious offence.
Well, look, the core was only picked for a moment.
Have you seen the sign here, madam? No picking at any time. Not restricted picking. Not picking on one side of the tree on alternate weekdays. And not eating time 20 minutes with no return within the hour. What's the name, sir?
It's Adam.
Adam? Is that one or two D's?
Well, please, your sub has never been written down before.
Oh, I see. First offence, eh? Now, tell me, what time was the call picked?
Well, you see, I picked it.
Right. And what is the registration number of the call?
One.
One. Right. Now, I'll just give you this picking ticket. You can either pay the statutory fine or be sentenced to purgatory without relief.
Harry, no! No! I will not watch Blankety Blank anymore!
No!
We'll pay the fine!
Now then, and I'd overlook the fact that the call was picked in such a way as to cause obstruction to other tree users.
Oh, good morning to you. I think that's a good start.
Do you mind not flashing in our garden?
Oh, I beg your pardon.
There have been a number of complaints, you know. Apparently somebody has been dropping litter all over this area.
Oh, litter! Litter! Very serious, is that?
Very serious indeed, sir. Yes.
Litter extremely serious.
All right, then give me that thing.
Got you, my lad.
Oh, but.
Never mind the but. You're covering me. Come on. By the way, mind my bike, will you?
Thanks for calling back to 3-2 once again. Good
Thank
to
you.
See you.
Oh, it's lovely to be with you again.
And listen, you've been around the world here since we saw you last.
Yes, I've been to New Zealand, of all places.
That's the first time you've been there, is it?
Yes, it's a beautiful country.
So here, I've got to Australia. I've never been up to New Zealand.
Oh, it's lovely. It really is a marvelous.
I'd like to do that one day.
Yes, we had great fun.
What are you going to leave these folks as leave?
Well, I'm leaving a parking ticket.
What else?
Yes.
Okay, a parking ticket. How about the room?
Everybody knows that. Right. The warden's been taken in. Will you be, or will you win?
Oof. There you are. Short and sweet, and here we go again. Ladies and gentlemen, Derek Guy. Thank you, Derek. Thanks for calling in. Bye-bye. Good luck. Well, again, short and sweet. What do you think? Any idea about that one?
Well, I still think that might be the bin.
Well, I tell you what, you've just heard that from Derek. I can read both of these two again.
Yes,
now,
I might.
You like, of course, the first one was brought in. Old Bill was brought in by Valentine Dial, and he said, if the bard is drab, new Latin, you'll grab. Now, whether that means any more to you that time, I don't know. The apple was brought in by Chris Emmett, and Chris said, before you get the core, you might well ask for more. So you've just heard the three in succession there, so now you have to make up your mind which one you're going to reject.
Which one do you
There you are.
I think
the parking ticket.
That's what Eric thinks. Yeah. And how about you, Jack? What do you think?
I think I'd like to drop grab bag, that one.
So you want to get rid of that, Jack? Yes? If you get through the elimination question? All right, Dora?
I'm going along, yes.
Jack, if it's wrong, you could have a right hand that we don't know. But so, Eric and Ruth, if you get through the elimination question, you want to get rid of?
Yes. Well, Eric does.
Eric does. She's thrown it right onto you, Eric, there.
I'm in trouble.
Okay, so two fellas have made the decision here. You're going to get rid of old Bill, and you're going to get rid of the parking ticket?
Yes.
If you get through. Right, well, good luck to you. Here is the elimination question. Now, if you'd like to put your hands, would you, beside that? Just not on it, because that would be slightly cheap.
I see.
You know, it might be easier to... Well, which would be easier to hit?
He's left-handed.
Well, would you want to turn around?
No, I'm fine.
So you can do, I don't mind. Go on, then. I was joking about the right-hander. It really could be one, couldn't it now? Hands beside that button, okay?
Yep.
I'm going to start to read this question. When you think you know the answer, hit the button, and only the button, and answer. Please don't answer before hitting the button. If you do that, I must offer it to the other couple. Yeah. And, of course, if you hit the button and answer and you're wrong, again, I will offer it to the other couple. Okay. If they, of course, are wrong, we'll carry on reading it until somebody gets it right. But good luck to you. Here we go. This is the elimination question. This is the most popular name for some world-famous gardens. They are situated near London. Jack's hit the button.
Kew
Gardens, you got it, Jack. You took the chance. Well done. Oh, congratulations. And about Dora was telling him off then. What did she say then? What did you say then, Dora?
I said I knew it as well.
Well, you should have hit the button then. Aren't you pleased he's done it for you? Story of his life, he says. Well, never mind. Marvis,
I don't organise him, though.
You don't I'm sure you don't, Dora. She doesn't organise Jack at all. Of course she does. Anyway, look, congratulations. You won the right to get into part three and hopefully take home a good prize, which, of course, means that we do have to say goodbye to Ruth and Eric right now. But Caroline's here with the money you won in the quiz. Caroline, how much was that?
£420.
£420, right? Not bad, eh? Your ceramic dusting bin there. And Ruth and Eric, if you just take a little look across there, Sandy has for you there a 365-day carriage cook. Now, that's just a consolation prize for you for a very happy 1984. Yeah. Thanks very much indeed, Eric. Ruth, take
Thank
care.
You.
Give him a round of applause, folks. All the best, Eric. Congratulations. Thanks for calling in. Bye-bye. That's it. You whispered that I ought to keep quiet, Dora. Now,
well, I'm the quiet one, no.
Oh, she's the quiet
one.
Can you imagine what the rest of the family must be like? Listen, Dora, we want you to do all your thinking and all your talking in part three. But what you've got to do now, hard part, think about that naughty, dusty bin, OK? We'll be back in just a couple of minutes, see what it is that they've rejected. And it is old Bill, right?
It's time for...
We're back in part three of Coming to the Garden Eve, and we've got Jack and Dora who've won the right to get through to where these big prizes are. Well, I'm afraid, Jack, you rejected, and I don't know how you could do it, but you've rejected old Bill brought in by Valentine Dahl, number one item, and he said, if the bard is drab, which is the word you hooked onto, new Latin you'll grab. Now, we know what your hope it is. What do you think?
I know what I hope it isn't.
Yeah. Well, let's have a look and see what it is. Okay, Valentine said...
A holiday in Stratford-on-Avon.
Oh, really? Well, I'll chuck it away and you can go if you like. Would you take me with you? I don't care. If the bard is drab, well, drab is bard written backwards, as Jack, you said that. And Shakespeare, of course, was the bard of Avon. So perhaps you should write that backwards. Wait a minute, we're not there.
Nova.
Hang on, don't...
Car, Nova.
New Latin you'll grab. Avon backwards, of course, would give you Nova. Yes, you've rejected the Vauxhall Nova. Ah! Well, never mind, we will go on. It's a shame, it's our prize, but never mind, we've got to think about that bin. Just think about him all the time. Years later now, of course, the family are all grown up, and Adam and Eve are preparing for a party.
Oh, fed up with it, here I am, fed up. Oh, good Lord! I haven't seen one of those in all my 180 years. I'm just a bit younger than Des O'Connor. I wonder what it is. No. Hello? Hello? Yeah? It's for you.
Tell them I'm out.
We say flash. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Round about now, we'd like to do a little tune that we just recorded and made unpopular. I'm alone in the Garden of Eden.
And you soon will be if you carry on like that. Now, have you got the food ready?
Yes, don't worry, dearest. I'm just lighting the hot cupboard.
Well, hurry up and get yourself ready. Seth will be back soon.
Oh, he's not bringing that Lander Nod mob with him, is he?
Don't be silly. It's just us and a few close friends. I told him it was going to be a nice, quiet family affair.
It's Saturday night and my parents are out of town. Don't tell all my friends at school that tonight we're gonna boogie down. Everybody's been spreading the word all over the neighborhood. Come on over and bring a friend. This party has got to be good.
Hey, we're having a party.
Everybody
gonna dance and play.
What I say now,
we're having a party.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
While the folks are away.
Well, everybody's shown up now. It seems like 101. The prettiest girls in the neighborhood.
The music is as loud as it can go. Everybody out of your chair now. It's time to hit the floor. Uh-oh, here come pulling up in the drive.
Here she comes.
Everybody make a run for it, cause there ain't enough places to hide.
No place to hide.
1 minute to clean up this place, or we'll be skinned alive. Just remember before you go,
next week, same place, same time, baby.
We're having a party.
Everybody
gonna dance and play.
Come on over.
Let's take it one more time. A 1, 2, 3, 4.
We're having a party. Gonna dance and play.
Everybody.
Woo. We're having a party.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
While woo, the folks are away. Hey, 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 hey.
Hey, no.
See you, folks.
No.
That was bad with the kids, dancing with the kids.
Absolutely. Yeah, yeah. You don't give in. You've got to face them. And we're all busy in pantomime this year.
Yeah.
Where are you this year?
I'm having a marvellous time down in Plymouth.
Not far from me.
No,
I'm talking.
No, you're talking. Lovely, yeah. Air, lovely down
what are you doing down
there? Babes in the Wood.
And you're
one of the robbers with Bernie Bursler.
Of course.
Interesting story, Babes in the Wood, but it's all right in the end, and we all sing a song. Isn't that a good idea?
Lovely. You can't miss it.
On a sheet. I bet you'd like to do that.
No, bring back Keith Debris, what we all say. What are you going to leave them? What are you going to leave him as the clue?
Well, I'll tell you what, I've got here some streamers. That's all I've ever to say. Some streamers, and then this is your clue coming
right,
up.
Okay.
This is it. Tonight, you've seen one outdoors, but now the chance is yours.
And that's it, Dora and Jack. Now we've got to think once again. Norman, Norman Vaughan, thanks very much.
Thanks,
Norman.
Nice.
Congratulations.
Thanks for calling.
Come on, mate. Bye. Lovely. Well, any idea, Dora, about
that one? It could either be the bin or it could
this
be...
is the problem with our prizes. They could either be the bin or they could be that, and that's why it's not really that. It's just a game of chance, really. I can read the apple, remember, which was brought in by Chris Emmett, or else the parking ticket brought in by Derek Guiler. Which of these two would you like to hear?
That was the Corn Double Moor.
Yeah. Corn Double what?
Well, it was Corn Double Moor.
Was it?
Or something.
So
something
Jack would like to hear this again?
Yeah.
Dora would.
Yeah. Oh, Dora. Oh, Dora. You didn't have to keep shifting at you two. Right. All right, Derek Guiler brought in the parking ticket and said, the warden's been taken in. Will you be or will you win? One's got to go. Which one's going?
Yeah. You want to do the streamers? All right. No, we'll have the litter.
You want to get rid of?
The litter.
The litter. You mean the parking ticket? Because that's a streamer and this
that's
is...
correct.
You want to get rid of the parking ticket?
The
okay,
litter.
That we've established. That's not bad, is it? Right. Derek said, the warden's been taken in. Will you be or will you win? Okay, yeah, keep your fingers crossed there, Jack. Let's see. Derek Guiler brought this in. The warden's been taken in. Well, if you remember, he was taken in for throwing the ticket away as litter. And then we warned you. Will you be or will you win? Well, you weren't taken in. You've rejected Dusty Bin. Yeah.
There he is. There he is. Yeah, you can bow. Bow to him, Dora. Give him away.
Yes, I know. You said you could do with it. Yeah, aren't you pleased?
Shall I tell you why? Well, shall I?
Well, yes. No. Well, you can have it if you want.
No,
you don't want it now. He's been rejected. I'm sure you don't. Marvellous. You've got rid of the bin. That means at least you go home with a good prize tonight, okay?
Okay.
Now we're going to have item number 5. Back to the party, which is now in full swing.
Well, sir. You've done it up awfully well.
Oh, thank you very much. Thank you.
Tell me, do you look after the place all on your own?
Oh, yes. Nearly, not quite yet.
Even more
Well, actually, it's not very difficult. The difficult part is thinking up names for the animals. That's it.
Lovely party. How about a drink?
No, thank you, no. That's Thompson. He looks after the gazelle.
You can't spend all your time chatting. Now go make some more punch and then see to the sandwiches.
Yes, dear.
With any luck, we'll run out of sand.
He's bone idle. Get on with it and give me another punch.
Yes, dear, I'm very tempted. I must ask young Kane what he did with that club.
Now, do make yourself at home.
No, thank you, madam. If I wanted to feel at home, I'd have stayed.
I'm this new diet, you know. It's a whiskey diet. Yes. I've lost 3 days already.
You're not eating.
No, there's nothing here to my taste.
Well, what sort of food do you like?
I like to bite things or squeeze them very slowly.
I'll see you later.
Always carry a little whiskey with me in case I get bitten by a tarantula. Always carry a tarantula with
me. Now, where is he? Bonnie, come here. Have you seen your father?
He's gone inside to open his present.
Present? What present?
It's for the new year. It's something he
said he wanted. Oh, Adam, where are you going?
I'm just showing this young lady around the garden.
But I thought you was opening your New Year's present.
This is my New Year's present. You know the saying, ring out the old, ring in the new.
Adam, just who is this person?
This is Eve.
But I'm Eve.
Yeah, but this is my New Year's Eve. Woo! Happy New Year, everybody!
Hey, listen. Hello, Dora. Hello, Jack. She just said, Jack says, can he change places with me?
When he knew,
when he knew you were coming into the table. She's lovely, isn't she? She really is. Listen, you're busy too in pantomime, huh?
Yes, I'm doing Aladdin at Chichester.
That's a great theatre, too.
Smashing it.
But I know
really
you're doing something that you really like doing. There's a great, great
yes,
play you're going to do.
Yes, I'm going to do Rattle of a Simple Man with a lovely Geoffrey Hughes.
Geoffrey
Hughes.
Katie
from Coronation.
Oh, yeah. Smash
it. Touring all around Great Britain.
There's a great play to do.
Great.
Lovely. Thanks for calling in, Babs. Now, what is this?
It's a Christmas decoration.
Just a Christmas decoration is your clue. And how about the run?
Right. It's home and away, willy-nilly. This could be extremely silly.
I'm sure it will be. They don't really care. The bin's gone, but they're still frowning. Thank Barbara Windsor,
good luck,
Barbara.
Thank you.
Bye-bye, love.
Bye. Good luck. Good luck. God bless.
Bye-bye, love. Thank you. Good luck. Well, now, Jack, what do you say? Just heard that from Barbara. Any idea what it could be?
Could be a holiday.
Could be a holiday, says Dora. Yes.
Could be a holiday.
Really? Well, you can hear the apple again, brought in by Chris Emmett, or the streamers, which Norman Vaughan brought you. What would you like to hear?
No, no.
Do we know that one? I can't remember.
Listen to that one.
Oh. I can't either, but Jack wants to hear that one again. Is that all right with you, Dora? All right. You can hear the one that Norman brought in tonight. You've seen one outdoors, but now the chance is yours. That is what Norman said. So, three on the table.
Like the dustbin,
does it? Well, there you are. Does I should think away from that. You've got rid of that.
Double-decker bus?
Well, you can have one of those if you want. I should. What are you going to go for?
Well, I don't really
knock that.
Whatever.
Knock that one. She's knocked the apple. Now he's knocking the streamer. What are you going to knock? The streamer?
Quick.
And we'll do the streamer.
All right, Jack. He's getting more confident as it goes on. Quick. All right. You're going to get rid of the streamers. Brought in number four item by Norman Vaughan, who said, tonight you've seen one outdoors, but now the chance is yours. So, tonight you've seen one outdoors. Well, in that scene, Adam's family was having a party. And, of course, the streamers would also have a party connection. But now the chance is yours, we said, and that's because that's what this prize is. We were going to give you whatever sort of party you would have liked at a top-class hotel near your home, and here to tell you all about it from the leading hotel and catering group, the tops in the country, Miss Rachel Carruthers, who's sitting just here. Rachel?
Lovely. Here you are.
Now, Rachel's been sitting there all very, very patient throughout the whole show. Now, listen, Rachel, you know, I'm not allowed to mention, of course, you know, the people you work for, but I trust that Well, I don't need to say any more than that, do I? But what is your position actually in the company?
I'm general manager of our hotel in York.
I see. Okay, well, I tried to tell Jack and Dora here about the party, but would you like to tell them what they would have won if they'd have had this prize?
Yes, Ted, the choice would have been entirely up to them, but they could have had perhaps an elegant dinner for 25 with a champagne reception, fine wines, or a dinner and dance with a classical carved buffet and a dance band, or perhaps a disco and a buffet. I'm sorry, I shan't be looking after you.
That is a wonderful prize. It has been rejected, and will you please thank Rachel Carruthers. Rachel?
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much indeed. Thank you. Well, okay, that's the streamers gone, and we're now down to the last two on the table, of course, and I can read both of these again. The apple was brought in, number two item, by Chris Emmett. Chris was a serpent. He said, before you get the core, you might well ask for more.
Well, I know it was something.
Now, you got that in your mind?
Yep.
Before you get the car, you might ask for more. All right, that's what Chris said. And, of course, Barbara, lovely Barbara Windsor, has just brought you in the Christmas decoration and said, it's home and away willy-nilly. This could be extremely silly. So, what do you
reckon?
All right, you're going to get rid of the Christmas...
I think it's a holiday. We'll see.
Well, I'm not opening this yet. Come on. Is it going to go or not?
Yeah.
It is? Is that okay?
Yep.
Right, it's home and away willy-nilly. This could be extremely, silly, which is what Barbara said. Oh, I've opened it now. It's home and away willy-nilly, so whatever happens, this prize is home and away. The decoration was predominantly holly, so this could be a holiday, but how... Could it be home and away if we sent you away somewhere in the UK? This could be extremely silly. You're absolutely right. A holiday to the Scilly Isles, and that's what... Look at that. Yes, we were going to take you by rail to Penzance and then by ship to St. Mary's, the largest of the Scillies and the centre of your holiday. First, a champagne reception at your hotel, and from then on, a chance to explore the beauty of the islands. An abundance of tropical plants and flowers greet the eye throughout the islands, and there are many rare species of both animal and bird life, which you would have seen on many of your excursions that were arranged for you. A fabulous 3-2-1 holiday. How'd you feel about that, huh? Have you been there before?
No, but at the moment they've got shortages, haven't they?
They've got what?
Shortages.
You know more than I do. I didn't know that. Well, never mind. If that's the way it is, thank goodness it's gone, eh? Okay. She's a fund of information, is Dora. Well, here's your prize, Jack and Dora. That's the one you stuck with all the time, right? The apple brought in by Chris Emmett. Before you get the call, you might well ask for more.
A crate of fruit?
Is that all you're going to go on with, a crate of fruit? I think we might give you 50 weight of bread pudding on top. Anything. Before you get the core, well, before you got to the core, you'd have to eat it or use a knife to slice it. So could it be something to do with eating? As the apple came in on a plate, perhaps cutlery or crockery, you might well ask for more. Asking for more is another connection with food, but asking wouldn't have been asking much more. Not much more than this fabulous prize. Just take a look at this, Dora and Jack. Tell you what you've got there. There is, would you believe, there's a six-piece dinner, tea and coffee set with the finest bone china, numbering 77 pieces in all, canteen of cutlery, and this fabulous 53-piece set of glassware. Look at that. Plus the money you won in the quiz, of course, which Barbara Windsor has. How much was that, Barbara?
£350.
£350. That's for you. There you have it. Dora gets a kiss. Jack, God bless you. Well, that's it. I'd like to thank everybody for looking in tonight, all our mates for being on the show. Till we see you again, Happy New Year, everybody. Take care. See you next year. Goodbye. Happy New Year. Oh, bless you. The non-drinker.